I'm at 33 North Dearborn Street in Chicago, Illinois, in front of an old, boarded-up Bank of America. It doesn't look like much today, but once upon a time, this was a stop on somebody's perfect day. This was the place where Ferris Bueller once stood on a float in the von Steuben Day Parade, singing Twist and Shout. Ferris Bueller's Day Off is my favorite movie, and one of the reasons I love it so much is that it takes place in my beloved hometown of Chicago. Many of the locations in the film look pretty similar to how they did when the film was shot over 25 years ago, while some are hardly recognizable. We're gonna go take a tour of all the places Ferris visited on his day off. But I don't wanna just look at the places. I wanna recapture the experience of Ferris Bueller's day off. We got a lot to do. Let's go. We're in the affluent suburb of Northbrook, Illinois,
where John Hughes, the writer and director of Ferris Bueller's Day Off, actually grew up.
Many of the suburban scenes from Ferris Bueller's Day Off were shot in Northbrook, or nearby northern Chicago suburbs such as Highland Park, Des Plaines, and Winnetka.
Interestingly, Ferris's house actually isn't in Northbrook, Illinois. It's shot in Long Beach, California. The fictitious name of Ferris Bueller's town in the movie is Shermer.
The scene where Jeannie is in the police station is the only time in the movie I know of with a reference to Shermer. There's a 1 second shot of a police badge with Shermer written on it. John Hughes likely called the town Shermer because prior to 1923, Northbrook was called Shermerville. Also, Shermer Road happens to surround the subdivision of Glenbrook North High School, which was the inspiration for many of Hughes' movie plots.
Turns out, almost all of John Hughes' movies take place in Shermer, such as Weird Science, 16 Candles, Uncle Buck, and The Breakfast Club. Or the characters happen to be from Shermer, such as the Griswolds in National Lampoon's Vacation, John Candy's family, the Ripleys, in The Great Outdoors, and Steve Martin's character, Neil, in Planes, Trains, and Automobiles.
Where's your other hand? Between two pillows. Those aren't pillows.
This is 538 Chestnut Street in Winnetka, Illinois. It's another suburb very close to Northbrook. And this is the real estate firm, Koenig & Stray, where Mrs. Bueller works.
Katie Bueller.
This is Edward R. Rooney, Dean of Students.
And as you can see, it's the exact same firm as in the movie. This is an important scene because we're introduced to Mr. Rooney, and we find out that Ferris Bueller has been absent 9 times.
9 times.
I don't remember him being sick 9 times.
That's probably because he wasn't sick. He was skipping school.
Jeez.
Between Cedar Lane and Meadow Road, right by the Glenbrook train station, we have the famous water tower that says Save Ferris on it. As you can see, it's been wiped clean. I think it'd be nice, in honor of John Hughes, perhaps to put the Save Ferris back up there. It'd be kind of like in Philadelphia, the way they put the Rocky statue next to the art museum. This is the window that the car goes through when it goes into the ravine.
Darker shade.